In this review, we're looking at the latest iteration of Diecast's Master's model of the Caterpillar 323 hydraulic excavator. And what's also new in this version of the model is that it comes with work tools. As usual, the packaging is excellent, and we get to the metal tin. As you can see, it has some really nice printing and photos, and on the back it includes information about the real machine. There are also photos of the extra tools, and these are a cleanup bucket, grapple, hammer and multiprocessor. Okay, so full of expectation, we lift off the lid, and as usual there's a Diecast Master's brochure, although perhaps surprising it's not the 2020 edition. Also included with the model is an instruction sheet, and on one side it covers how you can install the operator into the cab, and on the flip side it shows the four additional work tools, and it also gives you some guidance as to how to use the quick coupler. Included is some plastic tweezers, and as usual the operator is travelling in the upper deck, and the tweezers do allow senior management types to not actually touch the operator. Next we stick some fingers in the holes of the black foam, pull out the top piece and there's some more protection in terms of soft paper, and there we can see the model and the work tools sitting in the bottom piece of foam. After that it's just a job for the giant hand grab to get the pieces out, and there's just a bit more to do on the model, which is to remove the packaging from the crawler tracks. So for the assembly we'll just treat that as installing the operator, and to do that we take off the cab roof. Here's the operator, and it's a good job he's got his helmet on so he's not crushed by the giant fingers. Before we put him in the cab, let's take a quick look inside, and there's some nice detailing including cat on the seat back. Now we can quite literally drop the operator in, and we can use the tweezers to get him to sit properly. Starting underneath, and the model has decent metal crawler tracks with bolt head details. The base plate of the undercarriage is plastic, and there's some nice detail on the underside of the body. Focusing in on the crawler tracks and frames, there's some good detail, and that includes a pair of very tiny graphics. The cab has got a metal frame with detail in the casting, and there's a metal grab rail. The mirror attached to it is plastic, and it has some softness so it won't easily snap off. Looking inside the cab you can see a cat logo, and 323 is printed on the cab window. Looking in the cab window, the operator has his hands posed trying to show the size of something, and as you can see there's a windscreen wiper. Moving around the body there's the latest cat logo, there are panel handles and the grills are formed of graphics. On the counterweight there's paint highlighting and more sharp graphics, and the overall effect of all of the graphics is to provide a detailed appearance. Also nice on this part of the model are the metal handrails. The cover on top of the engine appears to be plastic but with an excellent colour match, and as you can see there are plenty of pleasing details. Also really good are the hydraulic connections which run to the boom, and there are textured walking surfaces. Moving up the boom there are soft hydraulic hoses, and the pipework in the boom casting is highlighted. Also painted black are the cables running to the work lights. Soft hoses cross over from the boom to the stick, which also has some small graphics. Moving down to the quick coupler, all of the rivets are painted, and the bucket that's fitted to the machine is a nice metal part with plenty of teeth. The model does come with other parts, so let's take a look, and we start with this ditching bucket or cleanup bucket, and it is a nice all metal part. Next we take a look at the hammer, and this is also all metal, and the detail level is very pleasing with all the many graphics. Next we move on to the grapple, and this is not all metal. The two jaws are plastic, but the colour match is perfect so you can't tell visually. This is another nice part, and you can see that the jaws have see-through grills, and the tool also has the ability to rotate at the coupler. The final tool is the multiprocessor. This one is all metal and it also rotates, and the many graphics add detail. The jaws can also be opened and closed. As usual, we start with the crawler tracks and they roll quite easily, and they are spring-loaded to maintain tension. Out on the Cranes etc. test track, the crawler tracks perform well, and it's easy to move the machine about and also to turn it. Whilst we're also here, let's check the rotation of the machine, and it's nice and smooth, with no rocking of the body. We move on to the digging functions, and to start, the boom raises to a decent height, with just a little looseness on the review model. As you can see, the stick can be stretched out, and the overall reach of the model is very good. If we move on to the bucket movement, it folds in quite a way, and if we open it up, it does quite well, if not perhaps fully. Next, we will fold it up small for transport, and it does well at becoming a transport load. Something else we always like to check is the ability to dig at depth, and here you can see the performance is reasonable. But it's not perfect, as you can see some of the piston is left exposed. Let's move on to the real plus point of this model, which is the quick coupler. It consists of a couple of plastic grips and they are quite tight. So at first use it can be tough to get the bucket off and then to fit the next part on. In fact, on the review model the grapple was particularly difficult to fit to the quick coupler. But using the supplied tools there are many ways to display the model. A 20-ton class Caterpillar machine has been modelled many times in the past, and this one is certainly the best yet. As usual, the presentation is excellent and there's a high standard of detailing. The functionality is very good, but the extra tools give it excellent flexibility. And so overall, this model is rated as excellent. Thank you.